So here in New England, snow load on a hoop house is a definite consideration and something to watch carefully. Especially if you have one of these Quonset hoop houses with the flat top. And this one, of course, is. And we have seen some heavy snow loads build up here. Heavy blizzard followed by a late winter rain followed by a freezing night. You could easily have several tons of snow up there in a short amount of time. So there's several considerations to manage the snow load. One, you saw on the inside of the hoop house, you saw my beautiful locust posts that were wedged into place under the center purlin, giving the spine a lot of support from below. That's a bit of insurance, but it's not adequate for some of the heaviest snow loads. Therefore, I watch the weather forecast, I watch the long-range forecast, and I don't go away if a big blizzard is predicted. I'll show you my tool for clearing snow. I've been through several incarnations of snow sweeping tools. This one seems to work pretty well. I can reach way up and bring the snow down. It tends to slough off like an avalanche in large sheets. And all I have to do is catch the right moment. Sometimes I can get the entire side of the hoop house to slough off all at once. It's kind of dramatic, and it's also nice to know that my hoop house won't be collapsing. Last winter, 6 hoop houses that I know of collapsed on one incredible February night when the snow piled up and was followed by a rain and a freeze. So if you put all this energy and time into building a hoop house, you don't want it to fall, you don't want it to collapse. So build it stout and be prepared to sweep snow some night at 3 a.m.